the open data Rwanda, we saw that there was a community that, you know, connects some of them and probably all of them. And this is why we started talking with Cartix or Exos on how could we have more activities to the communities that are interested in open data.
We have somebody from the civil society, Gatete. We have somebody from the public sector, Mr. Ivan. We have somebody from the private sector, Dr. Diana. And then we have somebody from the academia, Patrick. And we're going to hear from them in terms of how do they perceive data from their positions.
We've had traditional sources of data whereby we have people go out over a period of time, collect data on various things. We produce lots of different statistics. What the government of Rwanda has realized is that with technology and with various things happening, there are actually alternative sources of data.
You all know that today when you apply for a loan, it would take a week or two to assess, appraise the file. But today, I think with the computing power that we are able to have, people can apply for a loan and get instantly a yes or a no, or a limit, etc. So this is one of the big projects we have this year.
Now, how data becomes important is because data informs us of the baseline. Because for you to know what you've accomplished, you have to know where you were before, what effort have you put in, and where you are now. And then from there, where you can go after.
A lot of policy is based on gut feeling, right? We all think we know what's going on. And what we've seen more and more with data, especially in marketing, for example, is that with data, you can try very small scale experiments. And you can test the water and see what's going to happen.
Open data roundtable. So we want to have people from different sectors, you know, share their experience. You know, they have needs that some people in the audience can meet, or vice versa. Okay? So we want to have this on a regular basis.